Hi, I'm Brad Schmidt. I've worked with Balsam Hill to create some signature decorated trees for the 2015 catalog. Using ribbon effectively on a tree can look complicated, but I'm going to break it down into two ribbon techniques, cascading ribbon and finishing a ribbon. With these two techniques, you can recreate any of these looks at home. Note, you will need wired ribbon, since the wired edges let you twist and sculpt the ribbon to get the exact shapes you want. The trick to creating this look effectively is to tie your ribbon into the tree so that it comes in and out. The PVC tips that are already inside the tree are the secret to anchoring the ribbon down. They're already there, right there where you need them. Just make sure you use the PVC tip. That's the easiest for wiring the ribbon and anchoring it in. Also, when you're cascading ribbon, you don't need to use just one ribbon. For the silver and gold tree, I layer two ribbons of varying widths for interest. When you come to the end of the section of the ribbon, rolling the ribbon is a great way to finish it without cutting it. I'm going to show you three methods. The first is what I call croissant twist. Just curl the ribbon starting with the end, about six curls, then pull it down. It becomes like another ornament. The second is the reverse roll. It's similar to the croissant twist, but it is great for ribbons with such beautiful backing. It lets you show off the back of the ribbon. The third is to cut the end of the ribbon at an angle, or fishtail shape. And if you want interest, you can do a bow tie knot. With these two basic ribbon techniques, you should be able to decorate a tree in a variety of ways. See all of the ribbons and ornaments that were used to create these looks, as well as more holiday decorating tips on balsamhill.com.